Research gap with ChatGPT. Me versus ChatGPT. Can ChatGPT be an alternative for finding a research gap? In this video, we will compare my research gap and the research gap ChatGPT proposes. To know more about this, let's get into the video. In my latest video, I have talked about intermittent demand forecasting and also bootstrapping methods. In this video, we will see what research gaps we can find on this topic, intermittent demand and also bootstrapping methods. Then, after that, we will ask this to ChatGPT and compare the results. We will see if ChatGPT is giving better results for the research gap or our findings are more reasonable. And please drop your comments for this video and what do you think about ChatGPT's result and our research gap. If you have anything in mind to propose as a research gap, please feel free. So now let's see what we propose for the research gap. The research gap that I have found during my master's thesis on intermittent demand and bootstrapping method was proposing different lead times for the forecasting. To give more details about this, one of the bootstrapping methods called WSS method was being used in a study for different lead times. And my proposition to fill a research gap was to apply this method also for the lead times between 10 and 15 and also less than 3. As these lead times were not covered in the literature, I had proposed to fill this gap. Basically, this was my proposition to fill a research gap in this subject. Now, if you want to compare my research gap that I have found during my master thesis with ChatGPT, we have to first ask this to ChatGPT. So let's do it. Now let's ask to ChatGPT about finding a research gap on the subjects that we have discussed. So can you find a research gap about intermittent demand forecasting and bootstrapping methods? So we ask this now and wait for the response from ChatGPT. So for the first paragraph, it's giving a definition about intermittent demand forecasting and also bootstrapping, statistic bootstrapping. And then it's giving some examples here. So let's examine them. For the first one, it's giving an example about different bootstrapping methods and also different intermittent demands and trying these bootstrapping methods on these different demand types. It's quite general actually, but it's also giving you an idea, so it's not that bad. So let's see the second one. In the second one, it's talking about the parameterizations of different bootstrapping methods. So changing them, maybe changing the parameters of some bootstrapping methods. These can also be interesting to discover and investigate. So it's also giving an example. Here I would like to ask, can you be more specific on your second point? So it's giving a quite detailed answer about the different types applying different bootstrapping methods on different demand types. So let's ask about the third point. So lastly, I asked, can you give a research gap about intermittent demand forecasting and WSS bootstrapping? So here also the answer is quite interesting because it's giving a detailed answer about WSS method and how it can be applied to seasonal time series data. And also it's giving some examples on resampling methods. Here it proposes investigating different kernel functions for different data sets. Now I think we can discuss about the results.
I think the results are quite interesting because ChatGPT is giving some detailed answers about the two subjects that we had discussed, intermittent demand forecasting and different bootstrapping methods. In my opinion, it's worth using ChatGPT for finding a research gap, but I think you should not fully trust on ChatGPT on finding a research gap. And we have seen the results from the ChatGPT about finding a research gap on intermittent demand forecasting and also the different bootstrapping methods. And the results, in my opinion, are quite interesting, and it's worth considering ChatGPT while doing research, because the answers that we are getting from ChatGPT are quite detailed and also thought-provoking. It is really important to do brainstorming in research, so it might be a really great tool to use. I think to be cautious, it's better not to use ChatGPT fully for the research that you are trying to do, because it might give some detailed answers, but also it's giving some obvious results already you can find on the literature. That might be sometimes for you time consuming, and also it might lead you to a wrong direction in your research. I would be really careful about using ChatGPT as the only tool to find a research gap, but I think it's quite interesting and helpful, because even if you will not use the research gap that ChatGPT is finding, you can have different ideas from ChatGPT, and also you can develop the conversation as we have. And I think this would certainly give you some different ideas about the topic. To me, it seemed like a conversation you would do with your friend or with your professor when you are trying to do research, and as if they are really not fully aware of your subject in all the specifics, but they know quite a lot about the literature. So what I mean by this is you cannot tell to your friend or your professor that you are not working with all the details about your research, but only give some keywords about what you are trying to work on. They can give you their ideas as what they think and also what they have seen so far about those keywords, about those subjects from their mind. And ChatGPT here, I think, is giving quite the similar thing. It knows a lot about the literature because, as you know, it's using great amount of information, but that doesn't mean that it knows all the things in your mind. So it's better to ask the questions in detail, but not to trust fully to the answers. So about the comparison, we have seen the research gap that I have proposed during my master's thesis, and also the research gaps from the ChatGPT. The main difference is that you have some papers that you have already read and you have detailed information about your subject, but ChatGPT does only know the things that you had asked. So it's not always the best option to use ChatGPT as the only tool. And about the comparison of the research gaps, so the research gap that I have proposed for my master's thesis was quite specific and also detailed about a paper. For the other ones proposed by ChatGPT, they were quite general and they were not that specific as my research gap. And for my research gap, I am sure that, as I have did a literature review, that research gap exists and no research has been done on that specific topic and subject. But for the ones proposed by ChatGPT, I think we have to be still sure if these research gaps are really there and they were not covered by others in the literature. And also, if you want to have more specific research gaps with ChatGPT, I think you should ask more detailed questions to ChatGPT. And I would like to also hear your opinions about the comparison and your ideas about the research gaps proposed by ChatGPT. So you can drop your comments down. And if you like the video, you can give a like and also subscribe to my channel to see more videos. Thank you for watching this one, and see you in the next. Bye.